what's going on? I am Gregg Sussman, joined today by Davis Matic of DailyRoto.com, who's here to give you six future bets of teams to win the NBA championship this season. What's happening, Davis?
You know, we're on NBA All-Star break, so we're trying to do anything we can to find something to gamble on. I got bets out on tennis matches today, Gregg, so we're scraping the bottom of the barrel.
Hey, man. We got to do what we got to do. We got to earn a living here. So that makes sense to me. So let's put some money and lock it in the NBA. And let's start out in LA, where the Los Angeles Lakers are one of the favorites to win it all. And you like them at plus 300. I know it's not exactly a great number, but why do you like the Lakers here at that number?
So I actually do think it's pretty much a great number. I think the Lakers are the best team in the NBA. I think that LeBron in a playoff series is generally going to be the best player you can have. I think Anthony Davis is one of the five best players, and I think that their coaching has set them up to be successful, and I have no concerns about health, about chemistry, any of those things. And, you know, I basically do not feel that way about any other team in the NBA. I think that the Lakers collectively are pretty clearly the best team.
All right, the Lakers are Davis' best team in the NBA, and to get them at plus 300 when you got LeBron, you have AD, and Frank Vogel doing a nice job this season coaching. He likes them at plus 300. There's value there. So the Lakers, even though they're the favorite, worth putting a few shekels on. But that's not the only team that plays in Staples Center that you like here, Davis, because the Los Angeles Clippers are also at a good value, according to you.
So the Clippers are the most talented team. I think the Lakers are the best team, but the Clippers have the best collection of talent. You know, they have Kawhi, who when healthy is probably, you know, one of the three best players. They have Paul George, who's one of the 10 to 15 best players. They have Lou Williams, who's one of the best scoring guards. They have a center rotation with a defensive center and a scoring center, so they can switch that depending on the matchup. But they have health concerns. You know, Paul George basically has not been the same as to what he was in Oklahoma City and in Indiana after he had surgery on his torn labrums. We have Kawhi Leonard, who basically always has this knee injury, and it really has changed the way he's played. Now, he's still a great player, but it has changed the way he's played. I think that there are some coaching concerns there, and I think that there are some experience concerns with pretty much everyone other than Kawhi, but they are the most talented team. And if you look at the Western Conference odds, everyone else is so deep that I actually think there's a ton of value in just betting the Lakers and the Clippers.
Two of the clear best teams in the West. A lot of people have already written it in stone. That's going to be the Lakers and the Clippers in the Western Conference Finals. Get them both at plus 300. You don't really care who wins. You have a good shot in the NBA Finals. So lock in the Lakers and the Clippers. Let's move on away from Los Angeles here, Davis. And let's now go, well, to the Eastern Conference, where the Philadelphia 76ers are plus 1,700 to win it all. They have the best home record in the NBA. They've only lost twice at Wells Fargo. But away from home, not nearly as good.
No, they really are not nearly as good when they leave. But when we're going through this list, keep in mind, basically, I do not expect the Milwaukee Bucks to, you know, cakewalk to winning the Eastern Conference, and that's not the way it's priced on the FanDuel Sportsbook right now. They are actually plus 275 to win the NBA championship, so the Bucks are the favorite, and I just think that, you know, it's very hard when your best player does not shoot three-pointers, and the same is true for the 76ers. You know, their two best players don't really shoot three-pointers, but you're getting a much better price. You know, they were a bounce shot away from being in the NBA Finals last year, a matchup they probably would have won if, you know, the Warriors would have sustained the same injuries, and now they're plus 1,700, and I actually think the team is probably a little bit better as currently constructed, so I really like this price. This is, to me, is the best price on the FanDuel Sportsbook.
It won't be a cakewalk for Milwaukee, so why don't you go with another team that has a legitimate shot to win the East and ultimately see what they can do in the finals. He likes the Philadelphia 76ers. It's a good number at plus 1,700, so lock it in now before the momentum starts to build in Philly. Heading back out west, the Clippers, they're not the number two team right now in the Western Conference. That would be the Denver Nuggets, and you can get them to win it all at plus 2,500. Nuggets learned a little bit last year, and they pushed that knowledge into the NBA Finals and beyond this year, Davis?
It just feels like for my entire lifetime, the Denver Nuggets are going to win 52 games, be the three seed, and then lose in the second round of the playoffs. It really just feels like that is their destiny as a team. But Nikola Jokic is an incredible player. I think their young guards have a lot of ceiling in a playoff series, you know, kind of how we used to see those Spurs teams where they would, you know, you'd have Marco Bellinelli, you'd have Patty Mills. It's just, you know, you'd always have one of those guys who was capable of going, you know, 4-for-4 from three in the second quarter and just turning the game on its head. And I think the Nuggets kind of have some of that same potential. And, you know, they're a much better defensive team than you sort of expect that they are. And it's very hard for them to win a matchup against the Clippers or the Lakers. But, you know, the Clippers, they don't really have a great center rotation. And I think that they could potentially beat the Clippers in a matchup, I think, the Nuggets. So to me, that does make this price pretty intriguing.
Nuggets are well coached, and I agree with you. Listen, they have been in the same spot for most of our entire lives, the Carmelo Anthony years, and out here in the Nikola Jokic era. But if the Nuggets can do damage, man, as the number two seed, it's a tough place to play in Denver. I like the Nuggets here at plus 2,500. I think that's a good number. Let's head back out east. So the Miami Heat did a lot of damage at the NBA trade deadline, and they got a lot tougher. And toughness certainly can prevail in the playoffs. Getting the Heat at 2,500. Why do you think Miami has a shot?
So I just think Miami's really good. They have really good players, right? They have Jimmy Butler. They have Bam Adebayo. They have Kendrick Nunn, who's been one of the most, you know, surprising and impressive rookies. They have Tyler Herro, who's been way better than anyone really thought he was going to be in terms of, being a shooter. And, you know, the fact that they have so many capable shooters, they have a center who in the playoffs, Bam could play 38 minutes a night in the playoffs. Jimmy could play 38, 40 minutes a night in the playoffs. And, they're a team that's not going to beat themselves. Are they as talented as the Bucks or the 76ers? No, but they also are, you know, so much less likely to make mistakes. They are so much better coached than the 76ers are that they might even be favored over Philadelphia in a series.
The Heat are strong. They're dominant. They're a team that's going to bully their way deep into the playoffs. And you're right. Simply put, they're really good. So consider liking the Heat, because if it's not going to be a cakewalk for Milwaukee, and we'll see, the Heat has as good a chance as anybody, so consider Miami when making your bets. One final team in the Eastern Conference that we have to mention here is the defending champs, the Toronto Raptors, who was just on the longest winning streak in the league this year. 15 games it went out to, and that's, of course, without Kawhi Leonard. Why do you believe in Kyle Lowry and Nick Nurse to try to do it again?
They're just good, man. The Toronto Raptors are a good basketball team. They have 8 really good NBA rotation players. And, they are one of the only Eastern Conference teams that can really say that every guy that they give minutes to is a competent NBA player. And I guess their issue is going to be, you know, do they have a star? And they really don't. You know, Pascal kind of counts, but, you know, he doesn't shoot 3-pointers. So they kind of have that same problem as Milwaukee, where if your best player doesn't shoot 3-pointers, it's just really hard to win NBA games. But I kind of think that they might be like the third best Eastern Conference team, and they're not really priced that way.
Totally, they're not priced that way. People see what they are without Kawhi Leonard, and they don't have a superstar. They're not good enough. But Pascal Siakam is that guy, and if this team get healthy, we know they're battle-tested, and having proven they could already win, they're going to be a tough out. I like the Raptors at this price as well. One final thing I want to ask you, Davis, before we wrap up. You said it's hard to bet on a team that doesn't have a true three-point threat as their superstar. One team I noticed was not on your list was the Houston Rockets, who has like 7 three-point threats as their superstars. No love for the Rockets here?
You're just not going to get me to publicly say that you should bet money on the Houston Rockets to win the NBA championship. I totally buy all of the organizational philosophies for the Rockets. I think that every team should more or less play the way that they do. I think people actually are bored of how great James Harden is. I think Russell Westbrook is playing the best basketball of his career. But it's very, very, very hard for me to see that team beating the Lakers or the Clippers. I actually think, like, the Nuggets are a worse matchup for those teams. And as a result of that, I just, like, and the price is fine. So if you wanted to bet it, whatever. But if you bet that, you definitely can't bet the Lakers or the Clippers.
And that's why he's a lot smarter than I am. Davis Maddock, DailyRoto.com. We appreciate your time, man. We'll see you next time.
Hey, man. Thanks for having me. And, just good luck making it through NBA All-Star break.
And in order to get through the All-Star break, well, we got the WGC Mexico Championship, baby. We'll talk about it tomorrow with you and Jim Sonnes. Have a great night. We'll see you tomorrow.